Welcome back from the break. I'm Udaya Pratap Singh. You're with us live on NewsX. A week after two new COVID vaccines were, in fact, received emergency approval. That's, of course, Covovax and Corbivax. Their manufacturers are still waiting for further guidelines from the union government to roll them out. Nearly 1 crore doses of the newly approved COVID-19 vaccine Covovax have been dispatched after the final round of quality and safety checks at the Central Drugs Laboratory. A batch of more than 50 lakh doses of Corbivax has also been submitted for testing. Both Covovax and Corbivax are protein subunit vaccines. A jab, in fact, injects that spike protein that teaches the body to develop antibodies against the novel coronavirus. While the spike protein injected is without the virus, the body uses the antibodies generated to fight the real virus when it looks to infect the person. Joining us at this point is Dr. Naresh Chawla, National Joint Secretary, IMA and Vice President, Delhi Medical Council. We also have Dr. Vivek Gupta, Senior Cardiologist, Indraprastha Apollo Hospital, joining us live. Dr. Ankita Baidya, MD and DM, Infectious Diseases, AIIMS, is live with us. We also have Dr. Bhavna Barmi, Psychologist, Fortis Escorts Hospital, joining us live. Dr. Chawla, let me begin with you first. What explains the delay in rolling out these two vaccines for use in India? They've got emergency approval, but no further word on their deployment.
Frankly speaking, this is not long back. This was only last Tuesday. That means hardly 8 days back that the emergency approval for three things. Two of these vaccines, Corbivax and Covovax, and Molnupiravir, emergency approval was given. And after that, you know what I think? What has happened is the whole country was busy in perhaps vaccination of children and vaccination of the booster vaccination. And then this surge in cases of corona has occupied, frankly speaking, too much of time of everybody. But I personally believe that even if these two vaccines have come in the market, they are unit vaccines, but our earlier position of the existing vaccine, including Covishield and Covaxin, is fairly good. So it's not that the other new vaccines are not required or better vaccines are not required. Just that we came to know that more than 20 crore units of Covaxin are lying to be used. So everything, in my personal opinion, has got a little delayed. Even the children vaccination, even the booster vaccination, everything is perhaps a little delayed. So I cannot be pointing fingers towards anyone. Perhaps our preoccupation towards the surge in the cases of corona or this Omicron is perhaps maybe responsible for all this. But perhaps they did not raise much of this lobby. Reason for being, since already we have more than sufficient stocks of the existing vaccines.
Yes. But, you know, the big question, of course, being Dr. Gupta, over why, you know, it's been almost a year now since the vaccines were first deployed, first got emergency approval. In fact, it's been 1 year now because it happened, of course, at the start of 2021. Why no more than two vaccines are currently being doled out to Indians? Why no further vaccines getting clearance and being deployed? Is that a concern, Dr. Gupta, as we look to open it up now? For precaution doses in about a week from now?
This is a very valid thought process, I would say, Uday. And I generally agree that when we had 16 January, actually the precise date when the first vaccination drive was started with the Honorable Prime Minister was 16 January 2021, and now we are today is 5th of January. So we had initially only Covishield that was initially available to us. Then we had emergency use authorization of immediately Covaxin after a few weeks or a few months, and then we continued to do this. We had some Sputnik available to us coming from Russia, and then we were doing all the vaccination. I think there was some sort of a desire from our side that we should have Moderna and Pfizer vaccine also, which are mRNA technology, and also they had proven to be a little more efficacy because 94% or 92% efficacy was these with us, while Covishield with two doses was having only 72% to 80% of efficacy. And Covaxin almost similar. The reason why it has not been, I think DCGI is the approval body, which is Drug Control Government of India, which approves this, and they will approve only once they think that they will be available to us. The whole world was suffering from pandemic, and there was a major hue and cry, especially from the African countries, the underdeveloped countries, that they were not getting the enough stock. And therefore, when there was another reason, the most of the developed countries, including Europe and America, they stockpiled the vaccine and they did not give to countries like India or any other part of Asia, thinking that they may require it more and more. So there was a apadhapi sort of a thing, and they wanted to have their maximum stock for themselves, for their own countrymen. And that was the reason why the Moderna and Pfizer could not come to our country. But we did not suffer because of that, because we had enough supply of Covishield and Covaxin. And you know that we could do a maximum number of inoculation per day, because even if there was supply was available, there was a sort of a, we had reached a threshold of inoculating the population, and which was more than 1.5 crore in a single day. And we could reach to 65 to 66% of second dose vaccination in India. So although they were not available, our countrymen did not suffer, country people did not suffer because of the non-availability of other types of vaccine. This is number one. Secondly, now we have two more subunits which is coming up. And as Dr. Chawla told, that perhaps this was not emergency, that it should immediately be available. Of course, there are two subunits type of different type of technology which is being developed, which has been approved by USA and now being will be co-developed by Indian companies. And if they are available to us, that will help us, because finally we have to vaccinate the whole population. Now the booster dose has to be done to everybody. The reason why Honorable Prime Minister did not include 12 to 15 years of age, because possibly that he the ministry must have thought that there will be some sort of crunch at the availability of the vaccines, especially when you start thinking of 12 to 18. That means big number. Even 15 to 18 is 7.4 crore our population, young adult or children. While if you add to 12 to 15, the numbers will go up. So that was the reason. So there is no doubt that we require more vaccines, number one. Secondly, I think perhaps if we can start 24 hours vaccination. You see, the time is running like anything. If you have 10 lakhs of per cases per day in America, more than 2 lakhs per day in UK, and we are not far and we are not testing, we are not able to test that much, then I think we are at the point where we need to do faster booster. In fact, the booster or precautionary dose should come also for the lower age group, not only for 60 plus comorbidity, will also come. And therefore, at this point of time, there is always a demand and supply. You see, the demand is there. Supply is limited, and that is why you're not able to use that much of our infrastructure. I personally feel that there is a need of emergency sort of a inoculation or vaccination. We are satisfied with thinking that we have done that much, although only one day we had 1.5 crore inoculation, but that was of course a big number. But I think that we have to continue to do this, because still 30% of our population, if we start from two-year age group till 18-year age group, is partially it's absolutely not vaccinated. And while booster dose is now pending for at least 30 more crore population. So there is, I think you are this point of time when NewsX is talking about this issue, that means we are taking 1 mile forward. And we personally feel that we need to have more fast vaccination drive. We should keep on patting ourselves. That is one thing. But at the same time, we can use more infrastructure to inoculate, to develop something, so that more and more population is vaccinated as soon as possible. I was talking regarding this Omicron, the spread is so much. Now the country is facing a big problem, because although number of hospitalization is still not that much, but we are all fearing. A lot of healthcare workers are getting, despite double vaccination and one infection also, they are getting infected. Although mild infection, now the government has already told for 40% of reservation of the all the hospitals which are more than 50 beds capacity, including Apollo Hospital. So we are actually in stress. The healthcare is under stress, and we have to do the only Ramban at the point of time is vaccination, which will be useful in the later part of the third wave, or new variant may come. You see, I was reading a newspaper. There was 12 cases of different variant found in France, the UHI, which has not been yet going so fast, but Omicron is the 80% in India and 60% in America, 70% in America. So we have to be careful. Your point, NewsX point, Uday, your point, I really commend you for bringing this point, ki why other vaccines should not be available. And if they are available, then we will have enough infrastructure. Ours is a huge country with lot of primary health centers, Not only that, in fact, if I call myself in Apollo Hospital when we are inoculating children, we have done about 100 in first day one, day two, I'm not too sure about how many. So what I mean to say that still our capacity to inoculate or to vaccinate people is not fully utilized. So we can keep a target that, of course, we have to start rolling out 12 to 15 immediately. And then, of course, DCGI has to give approval for 2 to 12 also. Because the whole country, and then booster dose for young people. Younger means less than 60. So all these things have to really come up because our country, we don't want to come into the same problem as we had in Delta. And personally also, I'm little, although I have to give more morale upbringing to the patients and to the fellow people. But personally, the whole country is under stress. Personally, I'm also stressed. The country is under stress. The healthcare workers are under stress. And the country and, of course, ministry is also under stress, thinking that Omicron can bring 14 lakhs cases per day, which is not there at this point of time. One more thing, Uday, I would like to point out that I think this is not the time only for weekend lockdown. We have to be very, very careful and we have to really, thinking of economy, the government can provide. I will give you one example. In France, when during the wave one, I'm 2020, I'm talking, when the whole country was shut down, the government has provided 1,000 euros to everybody. All the people who were affected, especially those people who were not employed, not only I'm talking of private people. And this thing should come up from the government that they should not thinking that since economy will be down, you cannot put lockdown. If you don't put lockdown, the cases will increase. So we have to have a separate budget to provide to those semi people whose daily wages are earned by every day. So during this pandemic, the budget should come from the government to provide bread and butter to the needy people in the form of a special salary package, which will be a huge burden, I am sure about it. But you cannot, at the expense of not putting lockdown, increasing the cases number, putting a structural rest to the healthcare, and putting again, it will, because you see, finally the budget will be expending on the treatment. So that will be difficult. So I personally feel that putting a lockdown at this point of time, the nationwide, at least for 2-3 weeks or 4 weeks, will help. And if you can provide some food to the food or something like salary system, which France did, to the needy people who are actually dependent upon the daily economy, should be helpful to our country. This is my take because this is very important. We cannot, if we have 14 lakhs cases a day after 1 or 2 weeks' time, the things will be very, very difficult to manage, especially even with a lower hospitalization percentage. If the percentage is lower, but since the volume will go up, it will be difficult to manage. This is my view.
Okay. Well, let me in fact also quickly rope in Dr. Ankita Baidya at this point. Dr. Ankita Baidya, looking at the fact that vaccinations are going to begin again for the frontline workers and also for those above 60 with comorbidities, there will be further demand for vaccines. We've already seen over 1 crore vaccines being given in the last 48 hours to children between the age groups of 15 to 18. Once that demographic is vaccinated, hopefully the younger children will also be eligible. Looking at all of this, is it imperative that we begin now to allow the use of more vaccines in India, starting with, of course, the wide availability of Covovax and Corbivax?
So very true. So if we see this Covovax and Corbivax vaccine, so these both are subunit vaccine, and Covovax, it has been tried in the limited children population also and has been found to be safe. So as we are enrolling for the children vaccination, the booster doses also, so number of doses required, we are a huge population in our country. So as Dr. Gupta also mentioned, right now the Pfizer is not there, Moderna is not there with us, but Covishield and Covaxin, both the vaccines are doing pretty good. Boosters are required, though we are pretty late in starting the booster doses, but yes, now it has been announced for both healthcare workers, frontline workers, and the elderly with comorbidities. So with this and the children coming for the vaccination, new vaccines being approved and it's ready to launch in the market, it is very important that other vaccines, if it is available, so that we can vaccinate more and more population at a time, so that even the new virus strain like Omicron, it is coming maybe 3-4 months later, a new virus strain is coming, so the immunity doesn't go down. It has also been studied recently that three doses or four doses, like multiple boosters, like three doses. We currently are at the two dose stage. Now third dose has been announced. Four doses are even better. So if multiple doses are required in near future and we are having other vaccines also in our system, then it is possible to vaccinate such a huge population. Regarding mixing of vaccine, this is again a concern, that mixing of two vaccines, like Covishield, a person takes one dose Covishield, the other dose is Covaxin. So how to go about it? So limited data has also shown that it is efficacious, and in fact found to be more efficacious when these two vaccines are taken in an individual compared to the same vaccine when they are taken by an individual. So it's around 3 to 4 times. So when the mixing of vaccines are there. Similarly, some Western data is also there that has shown that even the mixing with the Pfizer vaccine, with these AstraZeneca vaccine, has also shown a better antibody response. So with looking at these data, even if the mixing happens with the introduction of new vaccines, I don't see anything scary with this. That vaccination is very important to control this pandemic. So this is an important step. Just upgrading with the healthcare infrastructure, if at all it is the situation, the US and UK will not worry, because their healthcare infrastructure is actually very good. But yes, still they are struggling with the control of this pandemic. So vaccination is very important. Introduction of new vaccines in the system, and yes, looking into the data and then allowing the mixing of these vaccines, like first dose, if it was a different vaccine, the second dose could be a different vaccine. In this case, if it is there, then we can vaccinate multiple people at a time, and the huge population of India needs to be vaccinated in a shorter time so that the control of pandemic is there.
Yes. Let me, in fact, also ask Dr. Bhavna Barmi at this point as well on this a big issue, Dr. Bhavna, because of course, there will be some who would want to take a different vaccine if that is allowed by the government. It's being done abroad, and we have to wait and watch whether it will be done in India as well. But do you believe that this is the need of the hour, that we begin to introduce new vaccines in India as new variants of the pandemic begin spreading, as we are seeing currently?
Yes, I think psychologically it is very, very strengthening for our nations and for the citizens of our country to know and have faith in the country's policies, that there is availability and there is newer availability suited to the mutants that are coming about, so that there is a protective shield psychologically that we can make around ourselves. Because what is very well known is that stress does bring down immunity. Now, if there is already a demeaning of immunity, and along with that, stress couples it up with further reduction, it's going to be detrimental for the overall health of our citizens. So I think it's very important psychologically also to support the citizens, support the community, that we are going to be providing the best of what is available in the world today.
Okay. Yes, it is, of course, psychologically reassuring, as you're saying. But Dr. Naresh Chawla, quickly coming back across to you at this point, as far as, of course, now the supply is concerned, are you pretty confident that we will have adequate supply once,
yes,
the vaccine opens up for the precaution doses as well? There is,
yes,
enough supply to cater to this renewed demand?
There are enough indications from the government which openly say they have enough stocks. One point more I like to make is this particular third wave is different from the second wave. Second wave, we know very well that the symptoms were more, the hypoxia was more, oxygen used to go down much more often, and the hospitalization was more. This particular wave is different because it is a disease, till now as we know it, is supposed to be milder. That means that our major emphasis should be on prevention. For prevention, again, the same things, corona-prepared behavior, which we keep telling through your channel and many other channels. And second is vaccination alone. I personally believe, as far as the healthcare workers go, 10th of this thing, Jan is a little late. No choice, but the matter of fact is lots of doctors I know all across India of members of Indian Medical Association, they already have become positive. So that means ki the ones who have become positive, they cannot be working in OPDs and ICUs and hospitals. So I only wish, even if it is late, there should be a huge supply of vaccines so that more and more healthcare workers, the corona warriors and nurses and paramedical staff and frontline warrior, workers and the 60 plus people with comorbidities. And as someone rightly said, we should start the booster dose of the other people also. If the logistics supports us, so I think there is all the more reason, because don't forget, when a booster is given, it takes minimum 2 to 3 weeks to have the good effect. So somewhere down the line, we are lacking behind, but that can be made up only by one thing, giving it more in abundance and to more and more people. That's how it can succeed.
Okay, last word to you, Dr. Gupta, before we end.
Right. Again, Uday, I really commend you, first of all. Give a pat to the NewsX. But at the same time, I really feel that we have to vaccinate faster than what we are doing. Although it is quite good numbers, we are doing it. But we have more capacity to inoculate. And the third wave is looming large. Not only because of that, because of course I'm very happy to hear from the psychologist that of course we have to keep on putting high morale so that we should not come under stress. But sometimes the stress comes out from my mind also, so I'm sorry for that. But of course the country has to remain happy all the time, because this is mild disease, there is no doubt. Few deaths are happening, but I am again scared with number of deaths which is happening to around 2,000 per day in America. So I'm a little scared about that also. But I think our immunity is better than them, and we have shown earlier, except for the Delta wave. In the wave one, we were not so much affected. The deaths was much lower. In this case also, as of now, already 2 months have crossed, almost 2 months, or 1.5 months since Omicron came to our country. And the number of deaths and number of hospitalization not very, very low. In Apollo, till yesterday morning, it was only 15 cases admitted, despite having more number of capacity to do it, and only one or two were on oxygen. So we are reasonably happier position. One should not get panicky, take precaution. A lockdown was my thought process, that maybe a lockdown is important, because only weekly lockdown in the 5 days opening does not make any sense. So if we can put a national lockdown or daily lockdown at least for 1 week, let us try for 1 week. This might help in propagating this. The rallies have to really come down. Election rallies can be more virtual. And that is also one of the reasons why the things can go beyond our control. And we don't want to face the similar problem as far as number of cases is concerned. So we have to be very, very careful. Vaccination, fast, as much as possible. Precautions. New medicines have come up. Monoclonal antibodies, the prices should come down. We will take another point. It's very expensive, but it's something like Rambar. The new antiviral medicine which has been introduced should be in the market as soon as possible. It is not available. Of course, there are 2-3 pharma companies which are making it, which is one of the something like better than favipiravir, I would say, because it has shown, the trials have shown that it is more effective than oral favipiravir, which we used hugely in the Delta or second wave. That's molnupiravir, which is our sister compound of the similar things which we're using. Remdesivir should be used. We should not completely ignore all the previous medicines. Patient treatment, early treatment is very important. As soon as you get symptoms, if it is, this is different. There's no loss of sense, loss of smell or loss of taste in this, but there is a high-grade fever with upper respiratory tract infection and along with cough, the sputum formation. This is small difference between the corona, which we had symptoms in the wave 2 as compared to this wave 3. We have a little sputum formation, a cough, and moderate to high grade fever. If these symptoms are there, don't ignore yourself. Do the testing. Lot of people are getting mixing that this could be simple influenza, and therefore they are not testing themselves. Why it is important to test? Because then you can isolate yourself. If you have simple flu without any COVID, non-COVID, then of course you cannot quarantine yourself. That to quarantine yourself to prevent infection to others, do testing. Don't avoid testing. Just think that it's
okay. I've run out of time. We'll have to leave it at that. My thanks to our guests for joining us.
For more such videos, subscribe to the NewsX YouTube channel. Hit the bell icon.